get me in the kitchen.
Yeah, here we go. Yes, I am. I am.
Okay, this is good. But if broccoli, cheese, and maybe some bacon bits is as far as you go when you're stuffing a potato, our next guest is going to take you way out of your comfort zone, people. Man. We are talking sweet potatoes. We're talking almonds and beans. You got to stick with us because we want to welcome the co-owner of Cafe 421, Antigone Sander McLeod.
Hey, how's it going?
Thank you.
Yeah. Isn't it fun?
This is so fun.
Corey says he likes to get in the kitchen. He doesn't like to clean up. Here's the good news. We get to cook today, and you don't have
to
clean up.
Yes. Nope. That's the best part about being here.
Perfect. So what are you doing here with these potatoes, Tig?
Well, you know, it's winter, and we're all trying to get some more health food back into us, but make it yummy. Mm-hmm. And so we've all had, like you said, the loaded baked potato with all the cheese and sour cream.
Yeah.
This is a refreshing, bright presentation of a sweet potato with white beans, carrots, some raisins, and some yummy Moroccan spices.
You're doing a Moroccan flavor, so for people who aren't familiar with Moroccan food, like what epitomizes Moroccan flavors?
Lots of flavor, lots of different seasonings. The spice blend that we're using today is called Ras El Hanout, and it has a mix of cumin and coriander.
One?
Yep.
Oh.
And you can make it, you could go online and make it yourself, or you could find it at a nice spice store already put together, and it's really, really warm and flavorful.
Yeah, that's delicious. Okay, so we've got onions going. What else
do we got? Onions, and I'm going to have you, Corey, add some ginger and some garlic that I've already minced up for you here. Yep, go right ahead. And we're basically just building our flavors here.
Nice job.
Nice, and you can instantly start to smell all those onions and the ginger. Amazing. And once you do add the ginger and the garlic, you only want to keep that on the heat for about 30 seconds or so because those start to brown a lot faster.
Okay.
And you don't want it to get bitter.
Right.
So while you're heating that up, I'm going to show you a kind of cool way to clean ginger.
Oh, that smells
because
so good.
Oftentimes you get that knobby ginger rod and you don't know how to attack it.
Yeah.
Right. Cut a chunk off, use your spoon, and you just shave it like that, and it gets that skin off.
Because when you cut it with a knife, inevitably you're going to feel like you just wasted
ton of it. Exactly. Yeah. So that's a really handy and safe way to clean the ginger.
I like that.
Now we're going to continue creating our sauté here, and you're going to add white beans.
Okay. Good.
And
just canned white beans?
I prepared my own from dry, but you can do whatever you like.
Okay.
Whatever's easiest. And then we've got carrots and celery, which you can add as well.
Nice.
Dump it in.
And I have diced everything to be pretty much the same size as the beans. So you get one even forkful.
Mm-hmm.
And we have golden raisins. I'll toss those in. And then last but not least, some OJ. Pour about half of that in.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can turn the heat up, Elizabeth.
Sure, I'll crank it up.
And if you're making this at home, you would bring that up to a beautiful simmer. Cover it for about 5 minutes. And then you're going to uncover it and add also the spice blend. Shake a good little...
What, like that?
Yeah, perfect.
Okay.
Stir it up. And then we've got some red pepper flakes. This is not a Moroccan ingredient, but I like it. And I know you like a little bit of kick, too.
Yeah.
And so the raisins are plumping in there. It's getting really sweet and savory. After you uncover it, we add some toasted almond slivers.
Delicious.
Wow. Delicious.
Man.
And a squeeze of honey, about 2 tablespoons or so.
So this is interesting because it's going to be like an exotic Moroccan dish, but really the only kind of ingredient that you wouldn't probably have standard is this spice blend.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
That's nice.
Yep. And then you just finish it off with the universally delicious lemon juice.
Oh, man.
So if you let this simmer for a while, it's going to look like what you have in that dish over there.
It's going to look like this. Yep, right here.
Mm-hmm.
It's got all sorts of color. It looks like, Corey said when I got here, sort of fall on a plate.
It does a little bit.
But the flavors are not as like earthy as the fall flavors. They're a little bit brighter.
So do you bake these sweet potatoes?
I baked them until they were like bubbly brown. You can see some little brown bits there. They smelled like marshmallows in my house burning.
Right.
They were delicious.
Yeah.
And they get nice and soft. And then you squeeze them like that and then just start to fill them up. You can garnish them with a little bit of parsley if you like.
Love this.
And you can eat them cold or hot, whatever you like. This is a great thing to take for lunch to work or something.
Yeah, wow.
And you don't have to just do this. If you have sweet potatoes lying around, you can do a little salad in a sweet potato. I roasted some radishes here. A nice fresh green bean salad. There's
a lot of options. Like a scene out of like Bon Appetit magazine.
It's pretty, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it really is. It's talk about like just being so into it when you see it and wanting to eat it. That's awesome. Truly. Antigone. Yeah. You got to give that a try.
Yeah. Here you go.
Try it out. This dig in.
Delicious. Ginormous sweet potato.
This is a good healthy portion here.
And Elizabeth drops her food on the floor all the time, so don't be shy.
Oh, wow.
Oh my gosh,
it's delicious.
Wow. Isn't that good?
It's like sweet and salty and spicy all in one.
Exactly.
And then the heat comes in and, oh yeah, delicious.
Yeah, and I can think of a million different uses for that bean mixture on its own, not
even just on rice or something.
Exactly. Right.
So good. So Tig's recipes are on the food page of TwinCitiesLive.com, and of course you can go and visit her at Cafe 421 in Dinkytown. Coming up next, take a spring escape from